Hello everyone, this is Muhammad Wasim and you are watching my YouTube channel. This is the first .NET video that I am making for my YouTube channel, and I have decided to talk on a very simple topic but yet much important, which is basically debugging. So I am going to share three debugging techniques in Visual Studio that are my favorite that could be useful for you as well. So let's straight dive to Visual Studio and see how it works. Okay, so this is a simple .NET API that I have created in .NET 7. Nothing else. If I run it, you would be probably familiar with this interface already. So there is nothing new in it. Yeah, you would have seen this Swagger demo and this weather forecast already. Okay, so what I have today to share with you. So the first technique that I am going to share with you is very simple, and you would be probably aware about it. It's putting breakpoints. Yeah, so this is the first way through which we can put breakpoints, and it could be helpful. So what it basically does, when we put breakpoint and when we hit this function, basically at this line the program will stop. But instead of putting breakpoints, I usually prefer writing debugger dot break statement, because it gives me kind of more control, and I like it instead of just a simple dot like this. Okay, so yeah, I prefer this. So we can see that how that does it work in the same way or not. Okay, I am running my application, and let's hit this API weather forecast, try it, execute, and yes, it has stopped here. So this is the first approach that I wanted to share with you. Okay, so what's the second approach that could be helpful in debugging? It's actually a one step next to this. So when we have put our breakpoint, then if we right click on here, and then if we see there, we have an option, quick watch. This is much helpful when we are dealing with link queries especially, and because it gives us control, and we can look at what our variable contains. For example, if I try to look at what forecast list contains, then see it has come 5, and it is displaying us all properties and everything else. And apart from that, if we want, we can check out that if we want to apply some where condition, or if we want to add, then it gives us control. So suppose in this scenario, if I want to check that, give me summary of all those, give me all those and forecasts whose summary length is greater than 5. Okay, so yeah, it has shortened the list, and it has only returned the elements that met the criteria. So this is the second approach that I prefer to use when I am stuck somewhere. Okay, so what's the third approach? The third approach is using immediate window. So here, if I go on debug and then I click on window, and then if I come here on immediate, this is the third approach. You can use this shortcut key as well, Control Alt I, but I think it's much easier to go via UI, but it's up to you how you prefer. If I click on here immediate window, it gives us this kind of screen, and here we can change whatever we want. Okay, so if I wanna look at what like I want to remove something from this list, first of all I would like to check that what is the count of this forecast list. See, if I have executed it, it has given us output that it has 5 count. And what if I want to remove some entry? Suppose I want to remove first entry. Okay, so it is saying that expression has been evaluated and has no value. And what if I come here, I can see that it has now 4 entries. So these are the three simple techniques that I use while debugging, putting breakpoints, adding watches, and utilizing immediate windows. I hope this video was helpful for you, and if you enjoyed it, I would ask you a favor. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel so you don't miss my upcoming updates. Thank you.